Hey friends, Dylan Bates here, the Final Cut Bro. Today we are going to be taking a look at advanced rotoscoping in Motion 5. Let's go. First things first, open up Motion. If you don't get the project browser, go up to File, New from Project Browser. After that, go to Import as Project and find the video that you want to import. After that, I'm going to shorten down this clip down to 2 seconds because rotoscoping takes a very long time and I gotta keep this tutorial short. So just find your 2 second mark, push O, and then I can shorten the duration of this project here. So what we're gonna use is called a clone layer. I will push K, or you can right click and do make clone layer. The clone layer, anything that I apply, let's say I add in a colorize, anything that I apply to this original layer will apply to the clone layer. So if I disable that original layer, we can make the colors all crazy and the clone layer is getting those same effects applied. However, if I apply, let's do it, maybe a defocus blur. If I apply a blur to the clone layer and disable the clone layer, the original video is not being affected. So to rotoscope this guy, if we click this down arrow and go to Bezier mask, we can zoom way in here if we push Command Plus, and then if you push space and then click and drag, you can move your image around, just like in Photoshop or something like that. So real quickly, I'm going to chop this guy's head out and then I will be right back. Okay, so we have this man's head cut out. Typically with rotoscoping, you need to go frame by frame. So we'd push the right arrow, move the mask, push the right arrow, move the mask, so on and so forth. But I'm gonna show you this super dope method of rotoscoping. So what we're gonna do is go to behaviors, motion tracking, match, move, and we're gonna apply that directly to the mask. Then if we drag in this original video, we will be given this red tracking marker. Let's just drag that to a good spot. So I like to do just above his eye. Here, it's a point of high contrast and easy for the computer to define, and then we will just push analyze. So that is going to analyze the motion of his head, and you'll notice that our mask is moving with his head as well. So that is going to save us a considerable amount of time rather than going frame by frame. As it is, we have a great track here on this guy's head. Now if the track isn't quite working, one method that usually helps it is if you click this down arrow, get your anchor point, you can drag that anchor point directly to where you did the track. Now, if we needed to clean up this mask, we can go over here to the masking options, go to our feather, and I usually like to do like -3 in my mask. So if I disable the original layer, we can see our floating head here is working great, and I did a really sucky job on his jaw, so I might fix that really quickly. So I'll just double click on our mask here, zoom in, and we can see if we can clean up his jaw a little bit here. And maybe we could take the roundness up one. There we go. So now we have a better roto around his head. And we didn't have to do individual keyframing. So from there, let's go ahead and enable the full layer. We're gonna select our clone layer because that's what we wanna actually be rotoing on. And we will get our Bezier mask tool. And you're gonna wanna overlap over part of the original mask that you did for the head. Okay, so we have the shoulders, and once again, we'll go up to behaviors, motion tracking, match move, drag in our frame there, move this tracking marker to a place of high contrast. I find right there on the shoulder works pretty well, and then we will push analyze. Okay, so now we can go into our mask and we can set the feather to something like -3, and then we can disable the original and just see that our masks are working well. I'm gonna drag the roundness up to 2 or so, just so it looks a little cleaner. Okay, so let's do the surfboard. So I'm gonna enable that original layer so we can see what's happening, and then we can select our clone layer. We're gonna add yet another mask, and this is a big benefit of Motion over Final Cut Pro, is that you can have multiple masks for a single layer, which is what you usually want to do for more complex objects. And I should explain, if you click and drag, you can get these rounded edges with the Bezier. If you push Command, both sides will be extended or shortened. If you just select one, one side will be extended or shortened. And if you push Option, it won't be moving around, so you can get a much cleaner edge. So let's say you want a huge curve over here, but no curve on this side, you can do that with Option. And that's getting us pretty good. Let's go ahead and bring up the roundness to 3 or so. And now I'm gonna show you with the motion tracking. We'll do motion tracking, match move. This time we're gonna apply rotation as well as just regular movement. So we'll do rotation and position, and then we'll just drag in our frame there. And this time it should give us 2 trackers. So there's one over here to the right, and we can just find a place of high contrast. I'm going to do this end of the board here and then apply the other tracker to this end of the board. And then we will just push analyze. And it looks like it didn't do too good of a job, but I think we can fix that. I'm going to change one to blue so we know which one's which. So our anchor should be here for the board. So to do that, we're going to click on this down arrow, go to our anchor point and drag the anchor to where the tracking is anchoring to. And that'll give us a better track. You can see that it's sticking a lot better to the board and applying the rotation properly. Also, let's go ahead. We'll disable this underlying layer, go into our Bezier mask. We can feather it with -3, and I might even drag the roundness up to 4, maybe even 5. Okay, so now we've got his head, his shoulders, now we need his knees and toes. So to do that, once again, re-enable this clip, go to our clone layer, and we will just do a single leg at a time because if you watch, there's a little bit of parallax, so the spacing between them is slightly different. So we'll just go to our clone layer, get our mask tool, and so on and so forth. So I'll apply this match move, find a point of high contrast and analyze. And let's disable this frame and just see how it's looking. It's looking not too bad. So now what we'll do is we will add a keyframe here in the mask settings under the control points. And we'll just animate the control points on the shorts flapping in the wind. Perfect. Let's go ahead and just roto the last leg and then we should be able to call it a day. So once again, we've done this a million times. Select our clone layer, select our Bezier tool, and we will just do a quick little track around the leg here. So we've got the leg. Let's go ahead and apply the track. Behaviors, motion tracking, match move, drag in our video frame. And we will take our point here, and I'm actually going to apply the anchor point down to that same area as well. Select our match move and push analyze and let it do its magic, and we'll hope for the best because this takes a long time, man. I'm done. I'm so done. Okay, so we've got our mask. Let's see how that tracked. It seems to have tracked it pretty well. Let's go ahead and apply some roundness, maybe 2 frames, feather it, -3, disable our underlying frame, and it looks like I missed an important part of our guy, which is unfortunate, but I will fix that momentarily. There we go, we seem to be getting a cleaner edge here. Okay, so we have our guy pretty well chopped out. I'm not super happy with all the edges, and if I was taking more time with this roto, I'd probably go in and clean those up. For the sake of the tutorial, I gotta keep it short. Okay, so we're gonna take in some beach footage I have here. We're just gonna move him from one beach to another, and it helps if your backdrop looks pretty similar in lighting to your original footage. Of course, that's not gonna work out for everything, but you know, that's general rule of thumb. And let's go ahead and select this group 2 and we'll push command and left bracket, and that will drop it in the group setting there so we can get it underneath our frame. Now you'll notice that the original footage is actually moving, so we need to do that same thing for this underlying footage. So we'll just go into our behaviors, motion tracking, match move, we'll drag in this frame and we will find part of the scene that tracks pretty well. His jawline seems to be tracking pretty great. So we will analyze that. Perfect. Now our backdrop is moving with our video there. Then we can take the scale on this and drag it up just a bit. Great. Okay. So now we could go into our guy's settings here, into our clone layer. We'll go to filters, color, and we're going to use the color balance. And so we can find an area in our image that is completely black. So we'll take our shadows, and this looks to be completely black. So we'll select that and it'll match similarly in the darkness here. Then we'll go into our midtones and you can click and hold and find a spot that matches relatively well. So this seems to look pretty similar here with this bluish area. And then we can go into our highlights and find an area that matches the brightness of what we want in our scene. We'll just click and drag and find what we're looking for. Great, so now we have our guy in the scene, and what we could do is maybe apply a shadow underneath him to really implement him into the scene. So we'll just create a circle here, and I will go ahead, we'll put it on group 2, make a circle, something like that, and it looks perfect. Let's go into our shape, and we'll change the fill to be black. Let's get rid of the outline, and then we'll feather it like crazy. Maybe shrink the size down just to implement them a little bit more into the scene. And this is all, you know, other aspects of VFX. So yeah, so now we have our guy and he's in a totally new scene, which is great. If you wanted, you could add a flare that matches what's happening on him to really implement him, but I don't have time for that. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time for a Final Cut Friday tutorial. Peace.